due to surface tension, silicone oil tends to be relatively cohesive and wants to remain as a single spherical bubble. When it is injected into the vitreous cavity, as in this case, and it reaches the artificial lens, it will only continue into the anterior chamber if there is a pathway that it can take, whether it's through a zonular dehiscence or rupture in the capsule, or as in this case, a patent peripheral iridectomy.